Welcome back to Texas Eats. Now we're here in my backyard getting ready to make a Shiner beer cheese. It's super easy, delicious, great for the holidays, for parties, and it only uses a little bit of beer, so you got a lot left over to drink. First thing you wanna do is get your bread ready. Whatever you wanna use, but I highly recommend sourdough bread. You can get it in loaves cut into slices, plus you can get some frozen pretzels from your local grocery store. And just pour some of this delicious melted goodness, all this butter. Once you have the butter on top of the bread, you get your favorite seasonings. I highly recommend onion, garlic powder, maybe a little bit of cayenne, a little salt and pepper as well goes a long way. Right behind me, I have my smoker going, and we're gonna go ahead and stick these inside and get them cooking. Right here, we have one stick of butter, about a half cup, right? We're gonna throw that right into our pot where we're gonna be making our beer cheese sauce. Put that down. Then we're gonna make a roux, right? Make the sauce a little thick. So you use equal parts flour and butter. I'm gonna put a half cup of flour in here as well. And right behind me on the smoker, we're gonna use the insulated firebox as kind of a little cooktop. And what you're gonna wanna do is cook this down, let it melt. And then we're gonna add milk in here as well. That's a blonde roux. When you're making a roux, you always wanna make sure you don't have any clumps in there because you want everything to cook. So you want that flour and butter to completely incorporate into each other. 1 teaspoon of onion powder. 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of dry parsley and oregano, and 1/2 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. Give it a little kick. Whisk all that up. Now we're gonna get some milk. This is whole milk, 2 cups. Now you don't want anything to seize up, so we're gonna pour in a little bit at a time and mix it in. Now you're gonna use about 1 1/3 cups of beer. Pour this in. Pour it at an angle so you don't get too much head on it. Same principle with the beer. You wanna kinda start whisking. Pour the beer in gradually as you whisk. Shiner beer is a great choice for making a beer cheese just because it has so many bold notes, especially the Shiner Bock. And then we're gonna mix all these seasonings with it. Before we add the cheese into our sauce, some Worcestershire, right? You can say it 5 different ways, you'll say it different every time. 2 teaspoons. You also want to add in your coarse ground Dijon mustard. 2 teaspoons. And right after we're done with this and it comes to a boil, we're gonna start throwing in our cheese. Now it's time to grate the cheese for the cheese sauce. I highly recommend grating your own cheese at home because it just tastes so much better than pre-grated cheese. This one right here, sharp cheddar. I have this really cool device here that's gonna catch the cheese for me. This one right here, Gruyere. This one has a nice pungent aroma to it and it melts really nice as well. This one right here, an aged white cheddar. Put some of that in there. Look at that. I got this device at HEB. It's like the coolest grater in the whole world. Look how easy that was. Let's check on our sauce. Take off the lid. Oh yeah, look at that. Nice and thick. You can tell that roux, the milk, the beer, it's all activated. It's working together. And see how creamy it is? That's the consistency you want. Now we're gonna start putting our cheese in, a little bit at a time, and just let it melt. You don't want big clumps of cheese in there. Look at that. We got some beer cheese, people. We're gonna let that finish up. Then I'm gonna pull my bread out of the smoker. Now that the beer cheese is done, our bread is toasted, the pretzels are ready. We have some meat on the side. We even have some cheese still left over. I'm gonna go ahead and grab one of these pretzels. Go in for the dunk. That looks absolutely incredible. Here's the bite. Super creamy, delicious, nice and salty as well. The seasoning in there is good, not overpowering, and the Shiner beer just kicks it up to that next level. The Worcestershire, the Dijon, everything just adds the notes that you want when you take that final bite. This is rocking. To get this recipe, all you have to do is head to our website, ksat.com/texaseats. Look for the link on there. You guys, super easy, great recipe for the holidays.